Hello, and welcome to the video instructions for ZooMed's Environmental Control Center, the 6-in-1 complete habitat automation system. This video will briefly go over the function, setup, and programming of the Environmental Control Center and its included wired LCD remote. The control center is a programmable habitat controller that automatically maintains the lighting, heating, and humidity of your pet's habitat on a daily cycle. It includes 6 designated power sockets for habitat devices, 2 temperature probes, and 1 humidity probe, and a built-in programmable alarm to warn you when temperatures reach extreme highs or lows. Both sides of the control center have 3 power sockets, each with a designated number and function icon above them. Socket 1 controls dimmable heat sources, such as incandescent bulbs or ceramic heat emitters. Socket 2 controls activity of connected heating or cooling devices, such as heat lamps, undertank heaters, or fans. Socket 3 controls humidity-related devices, such as foggers and misters. Socket 4 is a digital timer that can turn on or off a connected device up to 2 intervals per day. And sockets 5 and 6 are alternating on-off timers that swap power between connected day and night devices. Before installing the control center, the habitat should be completely built with the electrical devices in place. Take the included temperature and humidity probes and place them inside the tank in the area that you want to measure. Now place the environmental control center in a secure space outside the habitat. In the event of loss of power, the control center's memory will retain program settings, but the internal clock will need to be reset. You can now plug in the habitat's electrical systems and probes. Make sure each device and probe are plugged into the appropriate socket. The control center remote is made up of a large display screen and 6 front-facing buttons. The display screen is split up into 4 sections: socket 1 settings, socket 2 settings, socket 3 settings, and a section that displays the program time as well as settings for sockets 4, 5, and 6. To navigate the menu, use the socket button to cycle through the available 6 sockets. Once a socket is highlighted, the row button can be used to cycle through the options of the selected socket. The up and down arrow buttons are used to program the value for whichever option is currently selected. The clock button opens up the clock menu where you can set up your habitat's day starting time, night starting time, and current time of day. Lastly is the power button, which can be used to turn on or off any selected socket. Just highlight the socket you wish to adjust and hold press the power button for 6 seconds until the settings change. When first programming the Environmental Control Center, you'll want to set the internal timers and choose your preferred temperature scale. Press the clock button on the remote to access the clock menu. This will bring up the day starting time indicated by the day from message. Use the arrow buttons to set what hour you want your daytime devices to start. Click the clock button again to set the minutes. Clicking the clock button again will confirm your settings and bring you to the night from message. You can now set the start time for your nighttime devices. Confirming this will now bring you to the main timer menu. Set the timer to the current time. Make sure you have the appropriate AM or PM setting. The times you set here are reflected in the rest of the control center settings, so make sure they're correctly set to your needs. Once finished, you should now select your preferred temperature scale. Swap between the Fahrenheit and Celsius scales by holding down both arrow buttons for 6 seconds. If at any time you wish to mute all keypad or alarm tones, simply press and hold the power button and down arrow for 6 seconds. Now to program the socket settings on the control center. Select socket 1 with the socket button and cycle through the options with the row button. Day set allows you to set the desired daytime temperature for the connected device in socket 1. Night set adjusts the nighttime temperature. The value selected for the alarm option indicates how far off the temperature can be before the alarm goes off. For example, if your program daytime temperature is 80 degrees Fahrenheit and the alarm is set to 20, the alarm will sound if temperatures drop to or below 60 degrees Fahrenheit. To disable the alarm function, simply set it to zero. When the device is receiving power, a flame icon will be visible on the display. The percentage of power currently being outputted will also be displayed in red. Note that this dimming socket should not be used with mercury vapor UVB lamps, compact fluorescent lamps, or rock heaters. Now for a quick example. Select socket 1 by pressing the socket button and then the row button to highlight the day set option. Once highlighted, use the arrow buttons to adjust the recommended daytime temperature. Now press the row button again to highlight the night set option and use the arrow buttons to adjust the nighttime temperature. Lastly, press the row button again to select the alarm function. Use the arrow buttons to set the alarm value. The value set here decides how much the temperature can fluctuate from the program setting before the alarm sounds. The first option for socket 2 allows you to change between heat and cool mode. This will decide when your device turns on for this socket. Heat mode will turn on a connected device if the temperature drops too low, and cool mode will turn on a connected device if the temperatures get too high. Similar to socket 1, socket 2 has a day set and night set option to program the temperatures you want during those time periods. The next option sets the temperature difference. The value set here will decide how far habitat temperatures can deviate from the program settings before turning on. For example, if your difference setting is set to 15, this means habitat temperatures can either go lower or higher than 15 degrees from your program temperature before the device turns on. The last option is the alarm function, which works the same way as it did for socket 1. When you see the flame or snowflake icon, this means your device is currently receiving power. Now for a quick example. Select socket 2 with the socket button and press the row button to access the socket's heat or cool settings. For this demonstration, we'll use the socket's cool device settings, so I'll use the arrow buttons to swap to cool mode. Press the row button again to highlight the socket's day set mode. Here, you can use the arrow buttons to set your preferred daytime temperature for your socket 2 device. Press the row button again to set your preferred nighttime temperatures. Pressing the row button again will bring you to the temperature difference option. Use the arrow buttons to set the range that your habitat's humidity can fluctuate from your program settings. Press the row button one last time to access the alarm function. Use the arrow buttons to set the alarm value. The value set here determines how far the temperature can fluctuate from the program settings before the alarm sounds. Socket 3 controls the hygrostat function of your environmental control center. First, select whether you're using a humidifier like a mister or fogger or a dehumidifier like a fan. Set your preferred daytime humidity with the day set option and your nighttime humidity with the night set. Next, set your humidity difference. This will determine how far humidity levels can fluctuate before the device turns on. For example, setting the value to 5 will allow humidity levels to rise or fall 5% from the program setting before the device turns on. The humidity alarm option works the same way as the temperature alarms, where an alarm will sound if the humidity drops below or rises above the value percentage set. When the humidifier or dehumidifier is active and receiving power, a corresponding icon will appear on the remote. Now for a quick example. Select socket 3 with the socket button and press the row button to program which device setting you want. At this first menu, you'll decide whether you're using a humidifying or dehumidifying device. For this demonstration, we'll be using a fogger, so I'll want to select the humidify option with the arrow buttons. Next, press the row button again to open the day set menu and use the arrow buttons to set your preferred daytime temperature. Press the row button again to access the night set menu and set your preferred nighttime temperature. Pressing the row button again will bring you to the humidity difference option. This will decide the range that your habitat's humidity can fluctuate. Use the arrow buttons to set your preferred value. Lastly, press the row button again to access Socket 3's alarm function. Adjust the setting with the arrow buttons to set when you want the alarm to sound. Socket 4 is a timer that allows for two separate timed events to be programmed for the connected device. Set the first timed event by selecting Socket 4 and then selecting the 4-1 on option, indicating the on time for the first event. Once set, click through the next option, 4-1 off, to set the first event's off time. Repeat to set the second event, indicated by the 4-2 on and 4-2 off options. If you only want one timed event to be active, set your 4-2 on and 4-2 off options to the same times as the first event. Now for a quick example. Select Socket 4 by cycling through the sockets with the Socket button and press the Row button to highlight the option 4-1 on. Use the arrow buttons to select the time you want the Socket 4 device to turn on. Press the Row button again to confirm and open the 4-1 off option. Now use the arrow buttons again to select the off time for your device. For this demonstration, we're going to add a second timed event so the device can turn on and off later in the day. Press the row button again until 4-2 on is highlighted. Use the arrow buttons to select your on time and press the row button to confirm. Lastly, select the off time. Your timer is now ready to turn on and off two times throughout the day. Sockets 5 and 6 alternate power, meaning when one is on, the other will be off. Select Socket 5 and input the time you want the Socket 5 connected device to turn on. Next, select Socket 6 and input the time you want the Socket 6 connected device to turn on. The time you set for Socket 6 will also be recognized as the off time for Socket 5 and vice versa. Now for a quick example. Select Socket 5 with the Socket button and press the Row button to set the on time for your Socket 5 connected device. Use the arrow buttons to set the hour and press the row button again to set the minutes. Repeat for Socket 6. Remember, the on time for Socket 6 is the off time for Socket 5 and vice versa. Some things to note when setting up your environmental control center. In order for the remote to communicate with the control center, it must be plugged in. The control center is only as powerful as the devices you have plugged into it. Make sure your connected devices are capable of reaching your desired settings. The same goes for the type of habitat. A screen enclosure will not hold heat and humidity as well as a glass one. Plan accordingly. The alarms have a 30-minute grace period after being programmed before activating. When an alarm goes off, it can be momentarily silenced by pressing any of the buttons on the remote. If for some reason a sensor's reading goes beyond its capable range, special error messages can appear to help quickly identify the problem. If you see the error message EE appear on the remote, this means there's a problem with the sensor or the temperature range has been exceeded. Error message LL indicates an extreme low temperature reading. Error message HH indicates an extreme high temperature reading and will cut the power to the outlet. An error message, HF, indicates a high temperature reading specifically for socket 1 and will cut power to the outlet. Congrats, you've made it to the end. Hopefully this video has been helpful. If any other questions or problems arise that aren't covered here, please contact our customer service through the details on our website. We hope you and your pet enjoy ZooMed's Environmental Control Center. Take care.